Hello everybody, I am Dr. Jitendra Pandey, and in this lecture we will discuss about security threats pertaining to use of credit card, debit card or an ATM. The first threat is identity theft. Identity theft is fraudulent acquisition and use of person's private identifying information, usually for financial gain. It can be divided into two broad categories, application fraud and account takeover. Application fraud happens when a criminal uses stolen or fake documents to open an account in someone else's name. Criminals may try to steal documents such as utility bills and bank statements to build up useful personal information. Account takeover happens when a criminal tries to take over another person's account, first by gathering information about the intended victim and then contacting their card issuer while impersonating the genuine cardholder and asking for the mail to be redirected to a new address. The criminal then reports the card loss and asks for replacement to be sent. The second threat is credit card fraud. Credit card fraud is committed by making use of credit or debit card of others for obtaining goods or services. The threat emerges due to stealing of information like credit card number, PIN number, passwords, etc. Theft of cards and cloning of cards are also employed to commit such frauds. Hackers use complex techniques like phishing, skimming, etc. to gain credit card information from innocent users. Phishing. Phishing is a way of attempting to acquire information such as username, passwords, and credit card details by masquerading as a trustworthy entity in an electronic communication. Phishing is typically carried out by email spoofing or instant messaging, and it often directs users to enter details at a fake website whose look and feel are almost identical to the legitimate one. Skimming. Skimming is the theft of credit card or debit card information. Thief can procure victim's credit card number using basic methods such as photocopying receipts or more advanced methods such as using a small electronic device called a skimmer to swipe and store hundreds of victims' credit card numbers. Common scenarios for skimming are restaurants or bars where the skimmer has possession of the victim's credit card and makes note of card details for further use. Phishing. It is one of the methods of social engineering over the telephone system, most often using features facilitated by voice over IP or VoIP to gain access to private, personal and financial information from the public for the purpose of financial reward. The term is combination of voice and phishing. Social engineering. Social engineering involves gaining trust. Hence, the fraudster poses as a member of staff or even security guard. The fraudster would then ask the customer to check the card for damages. The fraudster would have gained confidence from his prey using various tactics such as offering assistance to the customer who perhaps would have tried to use the ATM without success, or perhaps the customer who is not familiar with the use of ATM machine and requires assistance. Steps to be followed before credit card, debit card or ATM card uses. Whenever you receive the card from the bank, make sure the mail is completely sealed and there is no damage. Whenever you receive the card from the bank, immediately sign on the card. Try to cover the last 3-digit numbers on the card. Register your phone number to check the account transactions. Change the PIN number immediately. Now we will discuss about secure uses of credit or debit cards at shopping malls and restaurants. Always keep an eye how the vendors swipe your card. Always make sure that the transactions happen at your presence. Never sign a blank credit card receipt. Carefully draw a line through blank portions of the receipt. Don't give away your personal information in the survey forms given in the restaurants or shopping malls. Now we'll discuss about secure uses of credit or debit card over internet. Always use secure websites for transaction and shopping. Please look for the signs of security. Identify security clues such as a lock image at the bottom of your browser, a URL that begins with HTTPS. These signs indicate that your purchases are secured with encryption to protect your account information. Always shop with merchants you know and trust. Always log off from any website after completing online transaction with your credit card or debit card and delete the browser cookies. Treat all email messages with suspicion to avoid phishing scam. Do not respond to email messages asking for personal information, including financial information, as banks do not ask for such information. Never send payment information via email. Information that travels over the internet, such as email, may not fully protect it from being read by outside parties. Please be careful when providing personal information online. Please be wary of promotional scams. Identity thieves may use phony offers asking for your personal information. Please keep your passwords secret. Some online stores may require you to register with them via username and password before buying. Online passwords should be kept secret from outside parties the same way you protect your ATM pin. Always make sure to use the virtual keyboard for net banking. Do's. Before you use an ATM, please ensure that there is no strange objects in the insertion panel of the ATM. Shield the ATM pin number during transaction. Don't forget to carry the transaction receipts along. Please change your ATM pin once in every 3 months. Keep your credit card receipts to guard against transaction frauds. Check your receipts against your monthly statement. Only carry around credit cards that you absolutely need. Shred anything that contain your credit card number written on it. Notify your credit card issuer in advance of your change of address, then you change home address. If you lose your credit card, please report the loss immediately. When you dispose a card at the time of renewal or upgradation, please make sure to cut it diagonally before disposal. Don'ts. Don't accept the card received directly from the bank in case if it is damaged or seal is open. Don't write your PIN number on your credit card. Don't carry around extra credit cards that you rarely use. Don't disclose your credit card number or ATM pin to anyone. Don't hand over the card to anyone, even if he or she claims to be representing the bank. Don't get carried away by strangers who try to help you use the ATM machine. Don't use the ATM machines if the device is not in good conditions. Don't transfer or share your account details with unknown or non-validated sources. Don't access net banking or make payment using a credit or a debit card from shared or unprotected computers in public places. Don't open unexpected email attachments from unexpected sources or instant message downloaded links. Delete suspicious email immediately. Don't give out your account number over the phone unless you initiated the call and you know the company is reputable. Never give your credit card information out when you receive a phone call. Don't provide your credit card information on a website that is not a secure site. Don't share any confidential information such as password, customer ID, debit card number, PIN CVV2, date of birth to any email request, even if the request is from government authorities like Income Tax Department, RBI, or any card association company like Visa or MasterCard. Don't address or refer to your bank account problems or your account details and password on social networking sites or blogs. Don't store critical information like your ATM PIN number on your mobile phone. I hope these tips will be very useful for you in your daily life. Thank you very much.